Welcome to this service, Christmas Eve. Some of us wait all year long to do this, and truly we've waited 2 years because last year we couldn't gather in person, and I am so glad that you are here again with us this evening on YouTube. I greet you with these lines from our psalm appointed for today, Psalm 96. Let the heavens be glad and let the earth rejoice. Let the sea roar and all that fills it. Let the field exult and everything in it. Then shall all the trees of the forest sing for joy before the Lord. For he is coming to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with his truth. Today, we celebrate because Jesus comes. Listen now to this call to worship. Rejoice and sing in hopeful praise. A precious child is born. Sing joyful songs of praise, for the Prince of Peace is in our midst. Rejoice and sing with hearts full of love. Christ is born. Alleluia. Amen. Our Advent liturgy for this evening is when we light the Christ candle. We have waited and we have prepared, we have sung and we have prayed, and we have shared the light of the world week by week. And tonight is the night. Tonight, the light of the world comes. Christ comes. The waiting and the preparing are over. A child is born for us. A gift is given to us. Emmanuel, God with us. Christ, who is born this night, is surely our light. There is no more darkness. This is a great light. Hear the words from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in the land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Here again, the words that tell us the good news of the bright light of Christ, Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Let the heavens be glad and let the earth rejoice. The blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, has come. We light the four candles from our waiting and preparing, hope, peace, joy, and love. And we light the Christ candle, our Christ, our light. Let us pray. God, your Son Jesus said these words, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Tonight, of all nights, we believe that. Let us follow closely this infant Jesus right up until he comes again to light up the world with his kingdom light. Amen. Our first hymn this evening is Good Christian Men Rejoice.
Good Christian men rejoice with heart and soul and voice. Give ye heed to what we say. Jesus Christ is born today. Man and beast before him bow, and he is in the manger now. Christ is born today. Christ is born today. Good Christian men rejoice with heart and soul and voice. Now ye hear of endless bliss. Jesus Christ was born for this. He has opened heaven's door, and man is blessed forevermore. Christ was born for this. Christ was born for this. Good Christmas. Christian men rejoice with heart and soul and voice. Now ye need not fear the grave. Jesus Christ was born to save. Calls you one and calls you all to gain his everlasting all. Christ was born.
Pray with me now this opening prayer. Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, be born in our hearts this night. Shine your light into the darkness of our world that all the earth may know your glorious presence and that all people might find hope. In your love and in your grace, in your glorious name we pray. Amen. This evening we'll be sharing only the gospel lesson, but we'll also share the part about the wise men from the east. We'll read a section of the Nativity story, and then we will share a song. We never can have too many Christmas songs. The first reading is from Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. In those days, Caesar Augustus declared that everyone throughout the empire should be enrolled in the tax lists. This first enrollment occurred when Quirinius governed Syria. Everyone went to their own cities to be enrolled. Since Joseph belonged to David's house and family line, he went up from the city of Nazareth in Galilee to David's city, called Bethlehem in Judea. He went to be enrolled together with Mary, who was promised to him in marriage and who was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for Mary to have her baby. She gave birth to her firstborn child, a son, wrapped him snugly, and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. Our first hymn, What Child Is This?
What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping. Shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary.
Luke 2, 8 through 14. Nearby, shepherds were living in the fields, guarding their sheep at night, and the Lord's angel stood before them. The Lord's glory shone around them, and they were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. Look, I bring good news to you, wonderful, joyous news for all people. Your Savior is born today in David's city. He is Christ the Lord. This is a sign for you. You will find a newborn baby wrapped snugly and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great assembly of the heavenly forces was with the angel, praising God, and they said, "Glory to God in heaven and on earth, peace among those whom he favors." Our next hymn is Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Joyful all ye nations.
Luke chapter 2, verses 15 through 20. When the angels returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go right now to Bethlehem and see what's happened. Let's confirm what the Lord has revealed to us." They went quickly and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. And when they saw this, they reported what they had been told about this child. Everyone who heard it was amazed at what the shepherds told them, and Mary committed these things to memory and considered them carefully. The shepherds returned home, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. Everything happened just as they had been told. Our next hymn, Infant Holy, Infant Lowly. Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 through 6. Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea on the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and the scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. And so they said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea." And then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men, determined from them what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the young child. And when you have found him, bring back word to me that I may come and worship him also." Let's sing together, We Three Kings.
We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts. We traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star.
Matthew chapter 2, verses 9 through 12. When they heard the king, they departed, and behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was. And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then, being divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed for their own country another way.
I know the well-loved song, Mary, Did You Know? You just heard it too. I know the song names Mary, and I know that that Mary that is sung about, that's me. And the lyrics of the song repeat over and over, Mary, did you know? Well, I am here to tell you, I definitely didn't know, not one bit. I didn't know a lot of things before Jesus was born. Truly, I didn't know a lot of things after he was born. I didn't know anything about what that song talks about delivering me, about kissing the face of God, about calming a storm. I didn't know any of that. But then again, I didn't really even know what was happening all along. Who would have known any of that? I was young and I was unmarried, and all of a sudden I was visited by an angel. I didn't know angels came to visit. Who would know such a thing? I'd heard about angels and knew well all about God. I'd heard about him for years. My father had talked to me about the Israelites and their story, but those kinds of things, those angel things, they never happened to people you really knew. The angel said, "You will have a son and you will name him Jesus." He told me I was highly favored by God. My first reaction was, this can't be. For a couple of reasons, really. I already was engaged to Joseph, and really, there was no way Joseph and I were going to have a baby if we were really married, not just promised to be married. My parents would be humiliated. I would be embarrassed and ostracized, talked about, ashamed. Joseph would never trust me again. It was something I truly didn't know how to manage. It was unthinkable. But then, more, when Gabriel said this baby would be God's son, well, I was speechless. The longer that angel spoke to me, however, the more I thought, I am no match for an angel or the Holy Spirit of God. Surely not God. And I had no idea how I would explain anything. It barely made sense to me. I didn't know how to take another step toward marriage to Joseph. But because it seemed like God really had found favor in me, that's what the angel said. He called me favored one. I said, okay, let this be as you said. And then the angel was gone, and I was left with this situation. I definitely didn't know what to do, or what to think, or where to turn. So I went to see Elizabeth. Oddly, she told me a similar story, an angel visit and an unlikely pregnancy, and she said, how can the mother of my Lord come to visit me? I didn't know why she would say such a thing. Who would have told her? That's another thing I didn't know. Eventually, I had to go back home and face the music. I didn't know what to tell my parents, what to tell poor Joseph. I had no idea. Never mind the walking on water part of the lyrics or making the blind to see. I only knew this. I had to walk into my hometown, my house, and somehow make everyone see that I wasn't what they were thinking I was. I was faithful to Joseph, and I was doing what an angel had told me to do. I didn't really know how to convince Joseph except to remind him I was the same Mary, the one he loved, and the one that loved him. Thankfully, I didn't have to do much because I guess I do know now that there are angels that help us. That's because, thankfully, Joseph also had a visitor. An angel appeared to him in a dream, too. Thank God for that. I told him about the angel who came to me. I knew he wanted to believe. He wanted to trust me, but he had been trying to decide what to do. He knew my life could be in jeopardy for what people accused me of doing. But Joseph, God bless Joseph. Well, I guess God did bless Joseph. The angel told Joseph to go ahead and marry me and that the baby would be called Jesus. And then, again, I didn't know how to manage the census that happened at such a bad time. I didn't know how awful that whole 90-mile trek would be from Nazareth to Bethlehem. I didn't know how hard those days of travel would be. The fact that I was very pregnant, that it was cold at night and rainy in the day, and even though there were others traveling without places to stay, I didn't know how hard that would be. I knew I didn't like traveling much anyway, being a small town girl like I was, but I didn't know just how hard that trip would be just to please the Romans. And I didn't know where we would stay. Joseph didn't either. And I didn't know anything much about having a baby. Oh, sure, I had a mom who told me things, but it's different hearing about it and then actually doing it. I didn't know what to expect. Poor Joseph, here he was, overstressed, overburdened, and with me. No place to stay, no time to worry about what we were up against. I did know this much. When a baby decides to be born, he is. I didn't know if we could do it. I truly didn't know. It didn't matter if I knew or not, obviously. And one would think that some answers would come once Jesus was born, but I didn't know what to make of what happened next. A bunch of shepherds came around, peeking into the little stable area where we were. I didn't know them, of course. How could I? But they came clearly looking for us, and they told us something amazing. We both had heard from angels months before, so we shouldn't have been surprised at angels appearing to them. But still, this time of my life continued to be so surprising over and over. I do know that. Those shepherds said an angel came and told them that a baby had been born and was lying in a manger. I didn't know if there was one more baby in a manger in this town, poor other people, if that were the case, but the shepherds told us that the angel said the baby was Christ the Lord. Then they said there was a lot of angels there singing. I didn't know angels came and sang. My experience, odd as it was that the angel came to say, "Hey, you're having a baby." I didn't know about singing angels, but I listened to the shepherds. They saw Jesus and they left, and I didn't know what to do with all that they had said, but I've thought about it a lot. I thought about it then. I've thought about it many times since. I didn't know what was in store for this baby Jesus, my son, God's son, but I knew it was something special. I didn't know how it would be after Jesus was born. I knew that we would go home. People could then figure out for themselves what was what. I didn't know how to raise a child that was God's son. I mean, what would he do that would be different from other boys his age? Joseph wasn't even sure if Jesus should learn his own trade or learn something else. After all, Jesus didn't come with an instruction book. We just didn't know. But in the end, we did know. In the end. But tonight is not a night to share all of Jesus' story right up to the end. It's not for tonight. I do know that. But in the end, we did know this. Jesus' birth marked the beginning of God's rescue plan for us all. A plan that meant Jesus would eventually die on a cross for our sins, trading his blameless life for our broken souls. He didn't have to, but he chose to, so that we might know the grace of his forgiveness and one day have eternal life with him. That I did know. And by the time it happened, so many other people knew as well. God's son, born in a crazy place with a wild plan that could have gone so bad, but really was such a wonderful thing. Truly a gift beyond measure. That I did know. And for lucky people such as you here tonight, you know it too.
Let's join together in a time of prayer. God in heaven, we are gathered here to celebrate your son's birth. It's a night of wonder. It's a night of starlight and songs of joy and praise. And it's a night when we are thankful over and over that we believe in you. We know that your son is our savior, and we welcome the good news of great joy. Christ is the Messiah, the one who saves. When the shadows of sin and sorrow surround us, shine on us with the light of your comfort and your grace. When the despair of the world overwhelms us, lift us with your promise of hope. When we forget the good news of your presence, cry out with your message of love that we might hear and remember anew. Christ is born. Christ is with us. Christ is the light of the world. We are not alone. Lord, we lift up to you in our hearts those we know and love who are sick and weary, who are anxious or overwhelmed. We pray for them and for those who need you, those who seek something they can't name. It's you, Lord. For those who tremble with fear or cold, those who have rumbling tummies or grumbling hearts, those with broken spirits or ragged lives, for those who cling to the last best thing, and those whose hearts pine for love. Bless us, O Lord, whom we adore, and turn our faces ever toward you, for peace, for grace and mercy, for hope and joy, for love that in you will never end. We want always to adore you, O Christ, like we adore you this evening. We pray now as your blessed child, the prayer you, baby Jesus grown to man, taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. No Christmas Eve is complete without candlelight, silent night. And I've done the best I can, folks. Enjoy.
Mother in
this benediction. Go forth and shine light in the darkness. Go and bring peace into our troubled world. Proclaim hope in the midst of despair. Go with God's blessing, for a child has been born to us, who is love for the nations and light for the world. Amen. Our postlude is Joy to the World.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room.
And heaven and nature sing.
Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains,
repeat the sounding joy.